Are you guys ready to explore and engage?
I know I loved wearing goggles when I was a kid. So we do have safety goggles if you want to wear them, but again, if you don't want to, that's okay. There's nothing dangerous going to happen.
ETHOS was founded in 2001 by a Bayer scientist, Patsy Baylor, and she had a passion and love for science, and particularly children and hands-on science. And so she ended up partnering with school districts and national science brands to serve as their curriculum fulfillment expert. So really what ETHOS does is school districts, or the foundation is, school districts purchase national science curriculums, and then each year they contract with ETHOS to refurbish those consumables. That's how it started. We also provide community outreach programming, as you were able to experience today with the field trips and hands-on learning.
Oh, I think you'll be all right, scientist. So the adults are gonna do this part right now, but I'm showing you, so then when you go home, you'll know what to do.
In our field trip that we were offering here, we were learning about rockets and what would cause a Alka-Seltzer rocket to go straight up into the air. So we talked about chemical reactions. The students took water and a tablet and we put it in a container. We took it outside, shook it up, and then stand back to watch a reaction.
We're gonna put the tablet inside. We're gonna put the lid on, shake it really hard, flip it over, and let's back up and watch.
And what's really cool about this is that all the rockets don't go off at the same time. So we had some that went off like right away, and then some took about 30 seconds, but then some of them actually didn't even go. So that was a great way to share that, you know, sometimes in science, things don't happen right away. And I learned a really cool word today. It was called a fabulous fail, which says sometimes in science, things don't go the way that they planned, but you know what? It's still fabulous, it's still great. And I think that's such an important idea to teach students that, you know, you had a plan, you did the science, and it didn't go the way, that didn't mean that you did something bad. It's just, that's how science is. So that's why we go back and redo our trials to gain more information.
The mission of ETHOS is to serve the community as STEM experts and leaders in innovation and education. Once COVID hit, kids weren't in school, so hands-on learning wasn't happening. And so we had to find a way to connect with kids in a way that was not usual for what we did. So we made up a program called Lab in a Bag. The idea was, instead of kids coming into this building or going to their schools and learning in a kinesthetic way, we would go to them. It was 5 simple hands-on lab activities with everything included. And we followed a learn, play, connect model, very simple and easy. We knew that kids learn best when it's hands-on, and they also learn and retain information when it's connected to something. There's one we did in the summer of 2022 called Creative Circuits, and it teaches kids 4 different electric circuits. It's a huge hit. It was part of our ETHOS in a Bag program, and it was really the lab lesson that launched us into our new national curriculum that we've launched this year that has really taken off.
Scientists.
Oh, yeah! So students each get a student data notebook, and on the front cover it says scientist name, because we know that scientists collect data. Each student gets their very own copy. It is in full color, and we have some color coordinated borders to help students and teachers differentiate between the pages. So when students see a yellow border, they know that's a data sheet. They are going to be collecting some data from one of the experiments they're doing in the classroom. When they see a green border, that's what we call a graphic instruction guide, or a gig sheet for short. And that shows students step-by-step picture instructions with some words to help them associate what they're learning and the numbered steps.
For decades, teachers would get their teacher's edition, we would go through training, and you would have to read 50 to 80 pages for a unit in order to get some background information on the unit. It was a lot of time, it was a lot of work, and a lot of teachers were having to do that outside of their school hours in order to get it done. The kids were not as engaged in the learning. At the end of it, they might learn how to do one circuit if you're learning about circuits. What we did is we created a program as we simplified the directions and the instructions for the teachers, and with our EIB program, they do 4 circuits. It's all hands-on, it's simplified. Kids ages 5 through 7th grade can use the same lab lessons. They can do it in a group setting or in a one-on-one setting, and they're getting a lot more out of it because they're having the experiences of doing it, using their hands, and being immersed in it instead of reading it in a book.
It's easy for the teacher to pop up a video and their teacher lesson because the materials are packed by lesson, so then the teacher doesn't have any prep time. They can just basically start their lesson on the spot. They don't need a lot of prep unless the teacher wants to kind of run down through the lesson. Therefore, the student is always engaged with the hands-on portion.
And then we're going to start our new experiment. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Miguel counted the cups of water as he poured them into the hole. What's the state that our water can be? Walter.
Solid.
Solid.
So far, it's been really smooth. ETHOS provides us with all the materials, which takes a lot off my plate, and I can be more in the moment with the students and their exploration rather than worrying about getting materials around. Just keep these awesome hands-on learning experiences coming. We like the fact that they're nice and short. Like, we can do these in 15, 20 minutes, which makes them really easy to put in the day.
Well, I learned the way that they think and the mindset of, you know, why they think something happens the way it is. I always love watching their reactions, and there may be things that, you know, they think is really cool that at first I didn't like, I wonder why that's cool. So I would go say, hey, scientists, you know, what's going on? Why do you think that happened? And just the way that they take information and put it together is amazing. I mean, that's why I love about education. And kids, I feel, are sometimes our best teachers.
Oh, the future of ETHOS is huge. Not only is we were recently awarded a $1 million grant from the Lilly Foundation, which was a huge honor. And the premise of that money is to scale both our ETHOS in a Bag program, which is our community outreach, as well as our GLC National Science curriculum, which has taken off. So in just a few short months, we are reaching well over 10,000 students in our curriculum alone.
I would definitely like to say thank you. I've been through several science curriculums since I've started teaching, and this is the first one that I feel like is really meeting my standards, and it's meeting the needs of the students. They're engaged, they want to do these lessons, and they're easy for both students and myself to carry through. And this is really what we need, and I hope more schools adopt this.